happy morning. It's Monday morning, and oh my gosh, yes, the magic of dance is calling me and saying, why don't you just be the ballerina? Just be the ballerina and dance and be beautiful. And oh my gosh, if only you were just a little skinnier, you know what I mean? Then it would be easy and everybody would believe so. Oh yes, she's a ballerina because she's so skinny. But no, 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 she does not evoke magic of dance because she's a fatso. So, therefore, I'm looking at my spreadsheet again. And so here's my spreadsheet. Oh my goodness, I can just fall into this, you know. Let's just fall into this instead of the magic of dance. Alright, what have I done here this morning? Well, it looks like we've had a little bit of a bring back of the market. It's happiness again. It's happy. China's happy. Everybody's getting happy again, so let's just deal with that emotion. Yeah, the rise of happiness all of a sudden occurs. Ah, ecstatica. It's a great day. But like I said earlier, if we make a world budget, if we budget each particular, I mean, it can be done. You look at the CIA factbook, you already know your imports, you already know your exports. You know what is needed to maintain that particular government in a financial stability, because really that's why wars really start, is because their financial stability is not sheer greed of a, hey, I need that land over there, because really that land over there is the provocations of all of these different cultures mixing together, and it's just disgust. So no, we don't always want to mix. Like the French don't really want Germany, and the Germans don't really want France. It's just not going to happen this particular. They just want to have their economy stay as a real stronghold. And so there. So in by using, like, we'll go back to the CIA fact books. We can use these data of collection, and we can really get into the ease of it. We can have, like, maybe that's it, you know, Zambia, I believe it's a country on the planet. It requires, you know, 54 million a year in export products. And so we just have to match this up around the world, and everybody is happy, and Zambia is maintained. And so there we go. And there we go in another fashion. And so we have economic stability. So that's all really that I'm discussing. And so not one gets the gamut of all. And so when we're looking like, oh, everybody wants to trade with the U.S. only, we fix that scenario, because we don't want everybody to trade with the U.S. because we end with a gluttony in an overpurchase of inventory and just a bunch of stupid products on the wall that nobody wants. So we need to have a you know. And then they would be like, you know, that's easy. Maybe we make it easy. You know, maybe we make it an easy trade situation. And so maybe if we use our particular, what do we call it? You know, our you know, maybe that is it. You know, if we already know the greatness and the ease of trade, maybe we can help other countries also. You know, this is how we do it. You know, this is our particular methodology. So perform in the same similar manner, and it will be easy for you. So if you want to buy products from Mexico, but you don't know how and you never have done it before, we'll tell you our way of how we deal and buy products from Mexico. So we need this particular, you know, instead of having them all swarm in, you know, all of India, all of Malaysia swarming in, you know, bringing in more and more products, because it's easy, you know, because we've made it easy. We need some kind of a stop, you know, stop. We've had our India imports this year. We can't have any more. You have to bring those India imports to other countries on the planet for your economic stability. And so it's just really a balance sheet of who didn't get India, who didn't get enough India this year, and who didn't get enough Malaysia, who didn't get enough Australia, who did not get the little cutesy, what do we call them, a New Zealand sheep shoes, who didn't get enough of them. You know, we have to go around and what do we call it, share that particular world market, and then we are a stable planet, all right, with that particular, you know, with the money anyway, with the money. My gosh, yeah, this is a terrible video. I know. Sorry. I ordered the camera. That's a funny thing. I think it's like $5 or something. I ordered one. We'll see if it shows up. Maybe it was $11. Yeah, I don't know. It may be good, maybe bad, maybe not. What is the other thing I've done? Oh, I added new things into my spreadsheet, and an approximate exit date, which is very important. Now, I'm like, well, how can I have that possibility? Well, when you go through all of the numerations, you can find out an approximate exit, a time that where that particular stock should have reached your goal. So if you are at like a 10% you want for that stock, that it would have an exit date. So yeah, these sheets are wonderful. If you can figure it out yourself, great. But yeah. So now I've added the approximate exit dates. Like here's one here, right there. Where's the exit date? Yeah. So I added this approximate exit dates, and then I also added what else? Jumps. I added jumps since I'm ballerina. Also, even without the magic, I added jumps. And the jumps are doing what? Oh my gosh, the jumps. That's kind of an odd one. The high jumps and the low jumps. Just what could happen. It's just that spur of the moment, the action that the stock can perform to. And that's just based upon historical. So if you've seen it, if it's had this type of like move, it's representing the move possible. The move possible in with others. So yeah. So it's, I know this is kind of a mixed up eclectic video, but yeah. I mean, that's it. That's it right now. Spikes. I don't know. I added spikes, but I'm not really sure if they're pretty much the same as jumps. Spikes and jumps. Yeah, pretty much the same. Anyway, I don't know. Just yabbering. Yeah.